You'll need 3 plastic cups, a potato, a knife, some salt, some sugar. That's about everything. You're gonna fill all 3 cups with water. Then you're gonna take 1 cup, fill it with salt, mix it in there, label it salt. We're gonna do the exact same thing with sugar, but except with sugar. And water is just water. You're gonna slice your potato into 6 equal pieces and then put 2 in each of your plastic cups. That's about all the preparation you need. And now, we wait 30 minutes. So it's been 30 minutes now, and we can finally inspect these potatoes. So I'm just gonna lay them out on a plate here, and label them, of course. There's no noticeable difference right away. So far, they just look like potatoes. If we have a closer look, this is the one that was left in just regular water. It doesn't feel much different, it's just a wet potato. Here's a zoomed in video of it. If I try to poke it or like scratch it, nothing really happens. Moving on, we have the one that was left in a salt solution. So right away, it feels a lot more flexible. It doesn't really look much different, it just feels different. When I try to poke it, it feels softer, but not enough so that I can pierce through it. Here we have the one that was left in a sugar solution. This one is slightly more flexible, but not to the extent like the salt solution one. But yeah, they had very similar effects. Now that I lay them out like this, it's very noticeable that the one that was left in salt water is significantly smaller, and I can't even set it up straight. It's just falling. It's flimsy. So why does this happen? Since we put salt and sugar in 2 solutions, there's less water in there because we put something else. We mixed something else in it. So because the concentration of water in the potato cells is higher, the water gets sucked out of there. Anyways, that's all for this experiment. I hope it made sense. Bye.